following that, we have the so-called gaseous creation. Gaseous creation is creation. First of all, we have to accept that the creation as we understand it is extremely limited, and extremely restrictive. The gaseous creation is assuming about creation that follows different physical laws. As we know, the gas is something that it tries to occupy any space you give it. So the gas actually will tend to move away and cover the whole universe. Okay? Yet, according to our own understanding, but it is very easily stipulated at this stage that you can have physical laws which will control this this tendency, this feature of the gas, something very similar like the creation of the concept of mass, okay, which will control the gas and give it some form of gravity. You remember that recently we had the announcement from the CERN Institute of the God's particle, and the fact that they found certain indications which on the basis of which some subatomic particle of great weight was capable by being in contact with other atoms to give them a sense of mass, and that creates gravity. That's well, that's as simple as that. That's what it is. Okay? So what I'm telling you is that soon enough somebody will come and will give you the probability of having another subatomic particle that will be able to give to the gaseous creation the capability of existing while in gas form. But that introduces the concept of different physical laws. Okay? Following that, we have fluid creation. Now, fluid creation, you may tell me, are you talking about the fish? No, I'm not talking about the fish, because the fish has mass. I'm talking about creation that has formations of creatures that they are fluid. But again, under various different physical laws, which will be capable to control the state of fluid. What we know as creation is something which is physical, follows, it has physical laws, it's actually very beautifully created, described by Newton. The Newtonian mechanics, they are actually written, and they are capable of giving us explanation of the mechanics of on our physical world. Okay? But the Newtonian mechanics will not be able to help us into the idea of fluid creation. You need more concepts to be able to make this creation capable of standing by itself. So at this point, it's still part of the metaphysical existence. And following that, we are moving, not here at the end, we are moving to creation that actually is close to us and identifiable by our senses. starting by animals and plants. Here we have animals and plants. And over there is human as well. That's what we are. We are an animal. Okay? Just an animal. Following that, we have the so-called microlife. All kinds of bacteria and microorganisms that live around us and around the other main categories of existences, which are plants and so forth, that they are wonderful creation as well as we are. And keep in mind that all of these creations, everything that is created, has a soul. Everything that is actually, we come across during our life experiences, is thinking. Everything expresses free will. It is the spirit within us, it's our soul that expresses free will. And what is the soul? It's nothing more than a gift from the spiritual hierarchy, from the spiritual world. It's a thought of a spiritual entity that one of us will be created with these features. And it is the result of a very elaborate cooperative and a lot of synchronous cooperation that many other souls are providing, that you eventually you are going to have the appropriate result, which is an apparently self-relying creation, such a human or a frog. So the microlife is very important. Fossils. Why do I have the fossils here? Well, obviously, because it's something odd. Fossils were alive and suddenly became stones. That makes them very unique. All of us are unique. But the fossils, they are changing state, they are changing zone. From the animals or the plants, they move into the stone world, into the minerals, really. Because they are stone, you can break them. Okay? So that's a beautiful question to ask. Why? What happened for the fossils to become fossils? Okay? I'm not giving you the answer now. But yes, it's a beautiful question. And they're a different category altogether. Okay? And finally, we have the minerals, which again have lots of questions. Lots of questions. And that's the beauty of looking at this model. This model gives you a home for all kinds of questions. And if you understand the models, eventually it leads you, it guides you and leads you to all possible answers. That's the beauty of this kind of models. They are very powerful. So at this point, I think we completed the reviewing of the materialization energy density zone model. And what I would like to do is take a few minutes break, and after that we can look at it and start asking questions and trying to find answers. Be sure that all the questions you will ask, they will be asked by many people, and they will be thankful to you that you phrase them, because you will be able to help them to be able to see more than otherwise. It will be just like they are with us today, even 50 years ago, later, which is another device of staying alive without being alive. Okay, thank you very much.